Welcome again, and at 2.29 we will take up to begin this particular session. So in 2.29 you can see actually we have Red and Company of Mumbai, which started a big branch at Bangalore on 1/4/2021, correct? And the question also states that to which goods were sent at 20% above cost. So rate of profit is 20% above cost. That means cost is 100, margin is 20, selling price is 120. So 20 by 120, that is rate of profit on what we call your selling price, that is invoice price. Correct? And as far as rate of profit is concerned on cost, that will be 20 by 100. Then branch makes both cash and credit sales. Branch expenses are met from branch cash and balance money is remitted to head office account. Normally, branch expenses are made by head office. But this time, what the question is stating, that whatever branch expenses are there, those expenses are met by branch from the branch cash. Correct? Obviously, it will reduce the amount of remittances, no doubt about that. The branch does not maintain double entry books of account, and necessary accounts relating to branch are maintained in head office. Following further details are given for the year ended so and so. Correct? So in this question, draw necessary ledger accounts like branch debtors account, branch stock account, goods sent to branch account, branch adjustment account, and branch expenses account. So in this question, we have been given cost of the goods sent to branch. Now cost of the goods sent to branch, that means goods sent to branch is given but at cost price. 2.29 is the question. So, first of all, what I am going to write here, goods sent to branch account. Of course, I will have to write it at invoice price. And it's a newly opened branch, no question of any opening balance. Given to us that goods sent to, the cost of the goods sent to branch is 1 lakh. That means it is cost, that means goods sent to branch at cost is given 1 lakh. So in order to convert it into invoice price, I will have to apply the rate of profit on cost, which will be 20 by 100, that is 1 by 5, that is 20,000. So that means in the current year, we must have sent goods at an invoice price of 1,20,000. In fact, we must have sent goods costing 1 lakh at 1,20,000, you can say so. So I will write here load on goods sent to branch account. So load on goods sent to branch account will be equal to 1,20,000 into 1 by 6. Rate of profit on selling price or invoice price is this much. Your loading will be 20,000. Further question states that out of the goods which you sent, remember one thing, head office sent goods worth 1,20,000, that is at invoice price. And out of that, 1,08,000 worth of goods have been received by the what we call branch. It means 12,000 worth of goods are still in transit. So that is why towards the credit side of the branch stock account, I will write here goods in transit. So that means 12,000 worth of goods are still in transit. We sent 1,20,000 worth of goods. Out of that, branch received only 1,08,000 worth of goods. Quite obviously, it means 12,000 worth of goods are still midway. That is in the transit. So 12,000, we will take the loading also. And I will write here towards the debit side, load on goods in transit, 12,000 into 1 by 6. That is equal to 2,000. Correct? Next thing which is given to us is credit sales, 1,16,000. Now credit sales, I need not require to tell you where I am going to put it up. Credit sales, 1,16,000. Amount of credit sales, 1,16,000. Now, as far as credit sales is concerned, it will also find place in the branch debtors account. You will write here credit sales. Very, very important question. 1,16,000. Not easy. It is not an easy question. 1,16,000. Then closing debtors are given to us as 41,600. Closing debtors, I will write here in the debtors account. Balance carried down 41,600. 41,600. Correct. 41,600 is the debtors balance. Then we have bad debts written off. Bad debts written off is 400. Once again, I will have to move to debtors accounts. And I will write here bad debts 400. And 400 worth of bad debts will also be reflected in the branch profit and loss account. I'll write here bad debts. Then in this particular question, we have been given cash remitted to head office. Now cash remitted to head office, that means total cash remitted to head office is actually 86,000. Total cash remitted to head office. See here, if I'm going to prepare this branch cash account in this question, and why I'm preparing branch cash account, I will let you know. We have been given that total amount remitted to head office, remittances, total cash remittance, that means total cash remitted to head office, which is given to us in this question, is 86,000. Cash remitted to head office is 86,000, which is given to us. So this time I'm preparing branch cash account. Why I'm preparing, I will let you know in a short while. 86,000 worth of cash has been remitted, correct? Normally, we never require to prepare cash account, but this time I am preparing due to one reason, I will let you know. And closing cash in hand is 4,000. Closing cash in hand is also given. So branch cash account, I will write here balance carried down 4,000. No question of any opening balance because it's a newly opened branch. So branch has remitted 86,000 and 4,000 worth of cash is still in the hands of branch. 4,000. Then we have been given cash remitted, again cash remitted by head office to the branch during the year. Now head office has remitted some cash to branch. So entry will be cash account debit. That means from the perspective of the branch, entry will be, because cash will come to branch account. So branch cash will increase. So remittances, but these remittances are from head office. Remittances from head office, I will write here. 6,000 worth of cash has been remitted by head office to the branch. Correct? These remittances are by branch. Branch office. Then closing stock in hand is given to us now, 12,000. So closing stock in the branch stock account, I will write first of all. This is your branch stock account. We haven't prepared branch adjustment account in this question. This is branch adjustment account. Closing balance, that is closing stock. Closing stock in this question is 12,000. I will write here 12,000. Then I will take the loading of closing stock also. I will write here closing stock 12,000 into 1 by 6. 2,000 will be your loading. Now we have got expenses at branch. See expenses at branch. Actually, this time for expenses, cash hasn't been sent by head office. Branch has met the expenses from the branch cash. Try to understand this time. When I'm saying whatever cash was there with the branch, out of that branch met the expenses. So cash with the branch will definitely reduce. In order to reduce the cash, I will write towards the credit side expenses. That is 24,000 worth of expenses has been met by branch out of petty, out of total cash available with the branch. Now 24,000 will reduce the cash, and of course these are expenses, will also be debited to the branch profit and loss account. 24,000. 24,000 worth of expenses. Right, here it is. Now all the entries have been put in, I think. Right, closing debtors, bad debts, cash remittances, closing stock, cash remitted, and all these things. So now we are in a position, first of all, in this question actually, do you think that I can close branch stock account in this case? What item is missing? Because it is very clearly mentioned in the question that branch does both cash sales and credit sales. We have cash sales, we have credit sales, but we do not have the cash sales. So we will have to find out the amount of cash sales. How to find out the amount of cash sales? First of all, actually, what you do, you find out your what we call cash receipt from debtors. In order to find out your cash receipt from debtors, you will have to tally your branch debtors account. Your balancing figure will be cash receipt from debtors. How much will be your balancing figure? 116 minus 400 minus 41,600, 74,000. So 74,000 worth of cash you must have received from debtors. So if branch will receive 74,000 worth of cash from the debtor, the cash in the hand of the branch will increase. So I will write it towards debit side to debtor's account. In the branch cash account, I will write here 74,000. Branch was not having any opening balance. 74,000 worth of cash. 74,000 worth of cash they have received from debtors, and 6,000 was sent by head office. Right now, branch is having 80,000. Try to understand this. Branch was having 80,000 worth of cash. Out of that, branch met 24,000 worth of expenses, also paid 86,000 back to head office, and still 4,000 worth of cash is in the hands of the branch. Is it possible? If you are having only 80,000 worth of cash in your hand, how is it possible that you can incur an expense of 24 and send back to head office 86,000 and still you are having what we call 4,000 worth of cash? It means there must be some more amount in your what we call hand. So the balancing figure in this case in the cash account will tell you the what we call cash sales. That means you must have received some cash from your sales, cash sales. So 24,000 plus 86,000 plus 4,000 minus 80,000. So that means balancing figure which I am getting now is 34,000. 34,000. So that means 34,000 worth of cash this branch must have received from cash sales. So that is why you will treat this item as cash sales. So in this question, amount of cash sale was not given, and in order to extract the amount of the cash sales actually, and we knew that there are some cash sales. So in order to extract the amount of the cash sales, we had to prepare branch cash account. I hope now you understand. See, 74,000 worth of cash. First of all, branch was not having any opening balance as far as cash is concerned. 74,000 we received from debtors, 6,000 from head office, total 80, and 34,000 from cash sales. So 1,14,000 worth of what we call cash is in our hand now. Out of that, we met expense of 24,000, 86,000 we sent back, and 4,000 still we are having. So you need to understand that in this question there are some cash sales to the extent of 34. So that is why I told you it's a pretty strong and important question. Cash sales 34. Now rest of the question you can manage of your own. All other important points I have explained. In this question there is surplus, no question of opening stock. So surplus, according to the solution, 54,000 is the amount of surplus. So this is how you are going to solve this one. 54,000 worth of surplus will be written in the branch adjustment account. Surplus 54,000. Now you can find out your gross profit 70,000. And then you will write your gross profit 70,000. And you subtract these two items to get your net profit, which is 45,600, according to the solution. So this is how this particular question will be done, correct? Not very tough one, but one important point regarding branch cash, correct? 2.30. Now we pick up. Concept in company with head office at City 1 has branch at City 2, to which the goods were sent at 33.1 by 3% on cost. 33.1 by 3% on cost. I will tell you a very simple rule also. First, you solve 33.1 by 3%. 33.1 by 3% means 33.1 by 3 divided by 100. First, you solve it. That is equal to 100 by 3, correct? Divided by 100, and you take 1 as denominator. Ultimately, if you will solve it, 100 will be cancelled. It is 3 by 1, or ultimately, it will be equal to 1 by 3. Is it clear to you? So, that being, our rate of profit is 1 by 3 on cost, because this figure was on cost. So rate of profit on cost is 1 by 3. 1 by 3 on cost means 3 is the cost and margin is 1. So you can write it this way also. Cost price is 3, margin is 1. So your selling price or invoice price must be equal to 4. So you can easily compute 1 by 4 as the rate on selling price and 1 by 3 as the rate on cost price. Is it clear to you or not? So this is how we can compute quite, and so often in many questions I have solved this one, so should not be a big problem for you. Goods sent to branch only is written, so we presume that these are at invoice price. Stock at branch only is written, presume it at invoice price. Cash sales returns, branch expenses paid in cash, and then we have branch debtors balance in the beginning, and we have discount allowed, bad debts, and also collection from debtors. Branch debtors check return dishonored. This line is also given in this question. Question is not very tough, to be honest with you, but still, I will solve it. So first I will write here goods sent to branch account. Goods sent to branch account. Goods sent to branch account is given to you as 24 lakhs. So you will write here 24 lakh. This is not the goods sent to branch 24 lakh. Then I will write in the branch adjustment account load on goods sent to branch account 24 lakhs into 1 by 4. That is equal to 6 lakhs. Besides goods sent to branch account, in this case, next item which we have got is opening stock. So I will write here opening stock. Opening stock is 1,20,000. So you will write here 1,20,000 opening stock. Then you will write here loading on opening stock 1,20,000. Into 1 by 4, that is equal to 30,000. Correct? Then you have got cash sales. In the branch stock account, you write here buy cash sales. Amount of cash sales is 9 lakh. After cash sales, we have got return of goods by customers to the branch. By customers to the branch. That means customers have returned goods to the debtors. So you will write here by sales return. What was the amount of returns? That is 30,000. Goods returned by customers is 30,000. In the branch stock account also you will have to write sales return as 30,000. Correct? You will also have to write it over here. Then we have got in this case branch expenses 2,67,500. That is 2,67,500 branch expenses. And it's pretty hot, so let me adjust the AC also. And then branch debtors balance in the beginning is 1,50,000 given to you, opening balance 1,50,000. Opening balance is 1,50,000. Correct. Then you have been given discount allowed and bad debts. Discount allowed and bad debts. Discount is 5,000, bad debts is 7,500. Discount 5,000 in the branch P&L. Ultimately, we will have to write discount over here. Bad debts 7,500. And in the debtors account also, we will have to write discount 5,000, bad debts 7,500. Then we have collection from debtors also 13,50,000. Lots of item related to branch debtors, 13,50,000. 13,50,000. And then you have branch debtors check return dishonored. Branch debtors check return dishonored. See, actually, when we receive any check from the debtors, we write entry BR account debit to debtors account. When we receive check, we write the entry BR account debit to debtors account. When we receive bill or check. If I am receiving check, I will write check account debit to debtors. Now, if BR or check is dishonored, then I will have to pass the reverse entry. So, I will write here to check dishonored. I will have to increase the debtors. So check dishonored in this particular case is 25,000. 25,000. 25,000, correct? And then we have in this case stock 2,40,000. So in the branch stock account, I will write here closing stock. And closing stock amount is actually 2,40,000. 2,40,000. Of course, I will have to take the loading of that. Loading on closing stock. 2,40,000 into 1/4. That is equal to 60,000. And then we have got branch debtors closing balance also 182,500. Balance carried down. So nothing as such in this question that you can't do it of your own. So now all it is remaining is to tally this one. So balancing figure according to the solution is shortage or deficiency, which is 10,000. Deficiency at cost or shortage at cost and loaded part you need to write. So first you write loaded part 10,000 into 1 by 4, 2,500, and shortage at cost will be written in the branch P&L. Shortage at cost. That is 7,500. First, you will have to compute the gross profit. The gross profit will be equal to how much? Gross profit is 5,67,500. 5,67,500. Now you can find out your net profit, and net profit according to them, actually in this question we have written shortage, but how it is short is 10,000. In this question credit sales were not given. First you must tally actually your branch debtors account, because I simply wrote the solution. Credit sales you will have to extract, and credit sales will be your 14 lakhs. I told you every time lots of information is with respect to debtors. Just skipped out of my memory to tell you that you need to tally it first to get credit sales, which will be equal to 14 lakhs, and now you will have shortage of 10,000. Still you can manage it, it's not a big problem. Net profit according to the solution is 2,80,000, and debtors account you have already tallied. You can do this question. There was only one point with respect to check dishonored. 2.31 is the next on the card. F88 Industries has its head office in Westview State and branch of it at City 9, to which goods were invoiced at cost plus 25%. So rate of profit on cost will be 1 by 4, on invoice price it will be equal to 1 by 5. Branch expenses are paid direct from the head office. Branch has to remit all the cash received to the head office bank account. From the following details relating to the calendar year, prepare the accounts. So in this question, I think you can manage, because it is simply written goods received from head office. No goods in transit is there. So you can simply write goods sent to branch 6 lakh. As I have written here, goods sent to branch account 6 lakh. Then you take the loading of this. Loading will be your 6 lakh into 1 by 5. That is 1,20,000, isn't it or not? Then you have been given opening stock. Likewise, you will write opening stock 60,000. You will take the loading of opening stock. Loading of opening stock will be equal to 60,000 into 1 by 5. That is 12,000. Next is cash sales for the year. You will write in the branch stock account cash sales 1,80,000. And then here you have return of goods by customers to the branch. By customers. So once you are going to write it Over here, against corresponding to credit sales, sales return, and then again in the branch debtors account, that is sales return 6,000. Then you have in this case branch expenses, so 84,000 worth of expenses you simply write in your branch P&L account. In branch P&L account, you have written 84,000. Then you have here branch debtors balance in the beginning 72,000, write in the debtors account 72,000. Correct? Then you have here discount allowed and bad debts. Discount allowed and bad debts will be written in debtors account first. Discount and bad debts you have written, and now you will take it to the debit side of branch profit and loss account. Quite simple. You are very, very well familiar with it. Closing stock is given 1,20,000. Closing stock. Stock at branch is given at 1,20,000, and here we have written 48. Please write it 1,20,000 closing stock. It's not 48, 1,20,000. You take the loading of this 1,20,000 into 1/5, and it will be equal to 24,000. Then we have got credit sales 3,80,000. So credit sales is given. You will also write it in the branch debtors account. Goods returned by branch to head office 12,000. You will write first of all in the credit side, and then you will take the loading also. That is 12,000 into 1/5. 2,400. So that's all. It's a simple question just for practice. So now you can find out rest of the things of your own, correct? So in this question, if I will tell you, your total actually is 1,32,000. Surplus cannot be written over here, cut it down. 1,32,000. And from 1,32,000, 1,32,000, I will subtract 24,000. I will subtract 2,400. And is there anything else in this particular question? Sorry, let me tally this one first. I tallied actually branch adjustment account. Your total is actually 1,80,000. Calculator is creating problem for me. 380 plus 12. Plus 120. Your credit side total is 6,92,000. Credit side total I am talking about. Total. From 6,92,000, if I am going to subtract 692 minus 60 minus 600 minus 26,000 balancing figure is your surplus. Sorry. And now you will write this surplus to the branch adjustment account. Actually, it is correct. And this surplus 26,000 is correctly written. I thought I was talking about branch adjustment. This is branch stock. Actually, this is branch adjustment. So, gross profit 1,31,600 is also correct. And total will be your higher. Then you compute your net profit. And finally, you can easily tally your branch debtors account. So this is all in this question. It is not very tough. It is self-manageable, no doubt about that. Correct? So you can do this question. And now, this question is for revision. Whatever we have done under section 1, correct? Whatever we have done under section 1 and under section 2, this question is meant for revision. You can easily manage it. It's not a big problem. I will go through this once. First of all, there is no invoicing in this question. You have been simply given branch stock, branch debtors, petty cash account. Suppose you are following the first method, data system. All these three items you will write to the debit side of branch account. Then goods sent from head office, you will simply write to the debit of branch account. I'm talking about the first system, data system. Goods returned, you will put it to the credit side. Cash sales, you will write remittances. Under it, you write cash sales. Credit sales, You write in debtor's account under first method. Correct? Then we have allowances to customer. It will come only in debtor's account in the first method. Discount also will come towards the credit side of the debtor's account. Even bad debts will also find place only in debtor's account. Goods returned by customer, sales return, it will also come only in debtor's account under first method. All these expenses you are going to put to the debit side of the branch account. Rent and rates, sundry expenses. Then we have been given cash receipt from sundry debtor. Cash receipt from sundry debtor, once you are going to take it to the credit side of the branch account, write it under remittances, and then of course in the debtor's account. Then these closing balances are also given to you. Simply put these balances towards the credit side. As you can see, we have to solve this question through debtor system. So I have already explained this. In the debtor system, you write opening stock debtors. So this is the total of the opening balance, goods sent to branch 26,000, and all the expenses we have written 8,200. Then by bank or simply by remittances you can write, that is cash sales and cash from debtors, total is 46,000. Then goods sent to branch, returns to head office 1,000, correct? There is no invoicing in this question. Closing balances we have written this side, and you can easily find out your what we call net profit. 63,400. This is your net profit under first method. Similarly, you have to solve this question under a stock and debtor system. And it is very easy. Again, I need not require to tell you, you can easily. Here we have written branch P&L. Actually, this is your surplus. Some people write branch P&L. You simply solve it in a manner the way we have been following. Correct? So this is stock and debtor system. Now don't wonder about Part C, branch trading and profit and loss account. You will do it by yourself, but let me first finish wholesale branch system. Then you can easily prepare branch trading and profit and loss account also. So solve this question only part A and B first. So with that, we come to the end of your section 2. And now when we'll move over to the next section, it is high profile section, wherein we are going to talk about list price and catalog price. Hitherto, till up to this particular point, I was simply telling you that 99.99% selling price and invoice price is one and same thing. But I also added during my discussions that unless and until otherwise stated. Now we will see that here we will have three types of prices, cost price, invoice price, and we will see that selling price is different. In fact, we'll talk about that list price and catalog price. These are very vital question, very important topic, but we'll take up this in the upcoming session. So till then, it's time to say goodbye.